Hey, Ms. McGurl, my staff, along with the primary staff, we have gotten together this summer and we've designed houses. We're going to do houses with the kids, and we're so excited about these 6 houses that all the kids will belong to and all the staff will belong to, but we need some crest. We need our each house to be represented with a crest. A crest is going to mean a lot to the kids and to the teachers because it is going to be what the house represents and what the house means to the kids as they go through the system of kindergarten, pre-kindergarten, all the way through 5th grade. They're going to belong to the same house. Like I said, there's 6 houses. So what we did is we took all of our staff and we let them, they joined a house, and then we let them design what they wanted in the crest. So we have the ideas and the concepts that we need in our crest, but we don't have the actual drawings or the actual artwork, and we need all of that artwork and these ideas put together to be one fabulous crest. Okay, our first house is Coraggio. Coraggio is the house of courage, and if you look at this drawing, it's just a sketch. One of the teachers did it, or one of the staff members did it, and they put together all the different things that they wanted in the crest that represent Coraggio. You can see the heart. Coraggio is about courage. My next one. This house, oh, this one's really cool. This one is double-sided. This one is Provola. Provola is our purple house. Provola is amazing. They have this sketch here where they have this symbol that means something to the actual adults in the house. And in some of these symbols, I don't even really understand what all of them mean. All right, our next house is Amistad. Amistad means friendship. And so we took Amistad, we had to send them back to the drawing board, and they came up with some new ideas. And this is their idea for what they decided their crest needed to have. It needed to have a dog, because a dog is man's best friend. And their whole concept behind Amistad is friendship. Now this one, Mangima. Mangima is my house, so it's the one that I'm like most passionate about. Mangima is the house of play. My house team came up with some of these ideas because, one, we love Legos, and Lego means play, and we feel that kids have got to play because they learn through play. Mangima rocks. That's my favorite house. The next one is Vadabus, and Vadabus is the blue house, and they have a few symbols up here. It's these swirly things. They mean something to them within their thinking. They have chosen the bear as their symbol for the blue house. And our last house is Fortham. And this is our greenhouse. And the greenhouse has a lion for its symbol, for its animal. They have fire and flames. They have this Celtic crest. And then they have a tree. And all of these things represent something in the greenhouse. I don't have the paper with me, but I can get that to you as far as what each thing means. But those are the symbols that they would like to see embedded into their crest. Now, all of these houses in their crest, we need them to where they can hopefully be put on banners and maybe even eventually on a t-shirt for the kids. So they got to be simple, clean lines, but they have to represent what the house represents. And so each one of these posters and the attached papers will help you understand the importance of each animal. And like I said, we want serious animals. We don't want Pooh Bear or cutesy little cartoon animals. We want the real animal, but we also don't want them to be scary, because again, we are running the houses pre-K through 5th grade. Okay, thank you.